Hey everybody, this lesson is going to cover the most important part of playing the guitar, and that is pressure on the strings. And why is this important? It's important because it will prevent tension in your hands and in your fingers and in your arms, and it will help you achieve good sound on the guitar. Now typically for a beginner, the problem is learning how to apply the right amount of pressure so that you're applying just the right amount of pressure to get good sound and not too much so that you avoid making the note that you're playing go sharp. Typically with a beginner, the problem is learning how to get enough pressure. So you hear the buzzing, you hear it sounds kind of muted. So what I recommend doing, and then you do this for each of your fingers, first through fourth. I'm going to start with my third finger, but you can pick any string. I recommend doing this on all strings, but you can pick any string to start with. And what you're going to do is you're going to lightly touch the string. You're not going to press down, you're just going to touch the string. And I'm picking that string. So I'm on the sixth string, I'm at the fifth fret, and I'm picking the string. As I'm picking, I'm gradually pressing down until I hear good sound. Right before the good sound, you're going to hear the buzzing. And then the buzzing goes away. Now, it's important in terms of where you place your finger inside the two frets. So I'm on the fifth fret. You want to get closer to the fret above. So this is the fret below. This is the fret above, meaning above, going up the neck. So I'm on the fifth fret. I'm closer to the fret that's in front of my finger or above, and I'm gradually pressing down. As soon as I hear good sound, and what precedes the good sound is the buzzing, because that means you're not getting enough pressure yet. As soon as you hear the buzzing go away and you have good sound, you want to register that in terms of the kind of pressure that you're applying. And then you start over. So you press put the finger back on the string near the fret. Pick. There's the buzzing. Buzzing goes away. There's good sound. And I now know exactly how much pressure is needed on that particular string with that particular finger. Now you want to go through this process with each of your fingers so that each finger starts to realize what is required to get good sound so that you eliminate the fret buzz. Now some things that can contribute to fret buzz might be the strings being too high, or you might have a fret problem. But we're going to assume that those problems don't exist and that we're dealing with a playable guitar. So the next thing you want to do is pick a chord that you know, one that you're working on possibly. I'll do a C chord because this tends to be one of the chords that's the first problem for many people. So I start with my third finger. You can even start with your first finger if you want, but I'm going to start with my third. And I'm going to go through the same process. So you heard the buzzing first. There's the buzzing, just a little bit more pressure, it goes away. Now, the key here is now maintaining that pressure while you apply a second finger, or literally your second finger. Strings open, first finger on the second string, and you go back and check, now other things that can contribute to buzzing or a note not ringing out properly is these fingers not arched properly. So that's a whole nother process to go through. You can start with your second finger, you get good sound, go through that process, establish the pressure, and then practice putting your third finger down and gradually, very gradually, rotating back and forth to establish that you have enough clearance underneath these fingers. But for our purposes right now, the most important part of what we're talking about is the pressure, because this applies to everything that you're going to play on the guitar. A common problem in terms of getting speed is being too tense. A common problem with not getting good sound is the pressure and also placement of the finger. But for beginners, the biggest issue is knowing how to get good sound and knowing how to be aware of the tension or the amount of pressure in your fingers in order to achieve good sound. So share this with your friends if you got some beginner students or friends that are beginners, and pass this along to them. You know, take time to practice on different frets, different strings with each of your fingers. All right, I hope this helps. I'll see you guys soon. And please subscribe.